Hello everybody, it's Eva from Bohemian Crafting here again, and today I'm coming to share with you a few of my lapbook journals, book pages, lapbook journals, or old book recycling to lapbook. I don't know how to call it that, but I have to say that this is pretty relaxing crafting, and I had lots of fun to work with it, and I'm still working on few of these books because it is relaxing. You can try so many new style pockets or so many different type of openings, flips, flops, flaps. I don't know how to explain all those things. First time when I saw those lab books, it was on Katy Orta channel, and I have to say her December daily, it's amazing, it's so gorgeous. And because I didn't know what that lab book mean, I googled it, and I was quite surprised that kids in so many countries, they are using lab books for their school projects, and they look amazing. And I found a web page which is called Lab Book 101, and there is so many amazing projects made using this lab book idea. So I've been learning a lot. I've been probably learning maybe from your kids as well, because there is so many amazing videos from kids when kids sharing their school projects made in this type of books, in this type of lab books. And those books are amazing. Their projects are amazing. And I was so surprised how much effort they put into it. And I have to say that I really enjoy it. And as you can see, I didn't use any embellishment at all. I used only book pages, only coffee dyed papers. And I really loved this project. I really loved those books. It's so cool to make them. It's very relaxing. And it's not too hard. And I'm gonna show you those books I've got done already. And I can tell that I'm still finding new type of pockets, new type of book pages. I'm still practicing how I can fold it, where I can make mistake when I'm doing these books, and how I can repair it, and how I can extend this book if I will change my mind, which I made. I made it here in this book. This book was before like this. It was just opening like this. And then I extended for those two flaps. This was my top cover, this one, before. And then I decided I want to have this one. So I just put two flaps. I glued them on my spine. It's very easy to work with this. You can kind of build up those lab books. You can make them large as you want, and you can put there so many pockets, so many openings. So I'm still working with it. I'm still trying to find some new pocket, new page, some new opening. Most of them, they've got many similar things, those books, or many similar pockets, because I wanted just practicing, but I really enjoy it. And it's so simple to work with book pages. You don't have to be worried. Here I also start to altered box. This is box from Christmas cookies. This box I really like because it has here small angel, and that angel was here as well. So I cut out that angel from here because I need to get some. When I will put inside this journal, which is fixed inside pretty well, and I didn't know it, I didn't meant it before. It was just made for each other. So I need some junction. I don't know how to say that. I need entry. Yeah, I need some kind of entry how I will take off the journal out of that box. So I cut out that angel from here, and I use that angel here. It's a small angel here. So then, because I've got these two angels, I put one angel here. It's not finished yet. I'm gonna put something inside. And maybe I will do a little bit more with this cover. I'm not sure yet. But even those small embellishments, they make that book really pretty. And here you can see I used a little bit different placing of my pockets. And it's still very nice. And it's still very funny. And I really enjoy to do those projects. You know, when you're working with decorative paper, you are very careful how you will work with them. But when you work with old book, it's kind of not like I don't mind at all, but it will be much more less painful if I will mess up, if I will glue something wrong way, I will don't be set too much. So it's really refreshing to work with those old book pages, and I really enjoy it. And here I started, I've got few more not finished yet. I'm still trying. And here I started to put a little bit decorative paper. I chose Graphic 45 that, oh my god, Communique, I think, Communique collection. Sorry for my breathing, we are fighting with chest infection in my family, so my breath is sometimes somewhere else when I am. I have to catch up. So here I used washi tapes and few papers from Graphic 45 and also few metal pieces, those metal elements, and it looks amazing. It makes that book pretty amazing. And this is from book pages as well. I used book page from one side and just linen paper from other side. And as you can see with this metal eyelet, it's beautiful. So I'm still working on few of them. Now I've got few days off from my work, which I am very happy. So it opened like this. I'm very happy because I've got a few days for crafting. I can enjoy it. Here, it's so many pockets here. And it's so many openings here. It can be opened like this. And like this. As you can see, it's a really huge amount of possibility what you can do with these projects, where you can place all those pockets, pages, openings. It's huge amount of possibilities what you can do. So today, I'm sorry, I think I'm gonna start to do small tutorial, and we're gonna start with cover, and then we will see how, or not how, where we will get. I believe that this can be shared in one video. Not in one short video, I'm sorry. But I will try to share with you everything I know, or everything I learned from you, from your kids. That's amazing. Oh my god. See how much we can learn from our kids, from our children. They are very, very clever, I have to say. And really, I will try to find that Labbook 101 website again, and I will put link down below. There you can see so many. They are not like scrapbooking projects, they are school projects, but when you will see those openings and those envelopes and those pages, you're gonna be amazed. I promise you're gonna be amazed. Those kids are wow. They are so clever and so creative, so you can find there so many inspiration. When I start to do these lab books, I was thinking that I need to find, for make my job much more easy, I need to find books which have same size of paper. I don't mean thickness of book, but I mean same size of my pages. So I choose those two books I've got here. This is old family law. I mean those paragraphs and advices what to do in some situation in your life, but it's very old and mostly all of them are not through anymore. So I'm using this book for my I'm sorry for my scrapbooking, and this is Mendelssohn please don't judge me. This is very old book. It's a very beautiful, beautiful old book. But this book I found in, in a bin, in my neighbor's bin when they moved out. So they just smash it to that large, I don't know how you call them. It's large when you're moving out and you wanna put to bin so many things, including furniture. So front of house was that bin and I took it off from there. But that book is amazing. It's so beautiful. So I'm using this book as well. Because that pages, those pages are gorgeous. So I've got this book and this book because they've got the same size. And I'm going to show you. We're gonna start with how to prepare your pages and how to put together the basic of your cover. Always when I'm taking some pages off, I'm trying to take full signature from my book. Here in this book, it's not easy to show, but in this book, maybe you will see that this book has many small signatures like this. So take it off, find some book you're gonna work with, try to take off all signature, or try to find that middle of your signature and take off this one. Not just separate page, but like this. It's like a pair of pages. So I've got prepared few of them here, but I'm gonna show you how I am preparing my pages. Here is signature from notebook. And here is signature from the family law book. And with both of them, it's similar. It doesn't matter how old book you've got. I believe even a new one, they will have same problem. As you can see, you can see here those holes from stitching. Same it's with that old book, it's similar. Also with old book, there is huge possibility that this will be ripped off. Here it will be huge gap because it's old and it's hardly used. So it's good to prepare your pages. I'm using masking tape, this one. I'm gonna find the end here. I'm using masking tape. You can use any washi tape you like, or any of these packing tapes, those plastic tapes, to protect your pages from falling apart. Oops. So I'm gonna glue it down over these holes, and I'm gonna glue it down from both sides. I don't think you have to do it from both sides. Maybe it's enough from one side. It's just, oops. It's just how I am doing it. Okay, here I will have huge amount. It's because I'm doing it this way, so I'm gonna prepare. Oops, no, come on. Yes, do not cut your page immediately, like I did now. It's because I'm sick. Oh my god, I think I will need not just pills for my illness, but I will need new gloves. Oh my god, glasses? Googles? Glasses. Now I confused myself. I think glasses. So I will see better. So, prepare your pair of pages this way. It will protect them from ripped off or falling apart. This, and I'm gonna do it from that other side as well, but I don't think you have to do it from both sides. I'm not sure. I think one side it will be okay. And those lab books are really great for practicing pockets. There is so many types of pockets, so many types of secret pockets. So those lab books are brilliant for practicing this one, because I believe you're gonna think same way like I do, that we will don't mind as much to mess about with to destroy those pages than if we will work with decorative paper, right? I'm thinking this way. If I will use like Tim Holtz paper, I'm gonna cry if I will destroy it, because I love that paper, you know. So I've got those two pages which I will use for my cover. One side will be like my back cover of my lab book, and because I like to make that back cover a little bit stronger, I've got here pardon me, I've got here this cardstock. This was between yogurts. Was there two layers of yogurt. You can use any cardstock you've got, any cereal box you've got. Just cut it to size of your page, one page. This is see, this is exactly size of my pages, which makes my job much more easy. I'm gonna buy much more yogurts, this yogurt, because it's much more easy work then. And I'm gonna use double-sided tape to glue it down. I'm sorry. Sometimes I've got question about glues I'm using, about trimmer I'm using. This double-sided tape, to be honest, I don't know which brand it is, because I found it on cardboard. I found on cardboard a small box with so many leftovers, and they don't have a name. They are all of them, they are like this, just small amount. I believe it was bigger, but someone used it, and then I don't know what they did, but it was there so many leftovers like this, and they don't have a name, so I'm not sure which kind of branch is this one, but it's sticking really well, so I'm using it. I need small between here. I'm missing a piece, so I'm gonna use this one. This has no branch as well. I'm sorry. It's just normal double-sided tape. No any I don't know, famous name. Just normal double-sided tape. I need some tool here. Sorry for my voice. And if my breath is too noisy, I'm so sorry for that. I'm fighting with chest infection. Also my son, I think it's from this house, because that house is so wet, and we're trying to fight with it, but to be honest, this house needs to be get down and built again, because it's too bad. My daddy is builder, and if he will see this house, he will, oh my god, he will be so surprised how we can live in it. So I'm gonna glue it down on my page. If you will see my head, I'm so sorry. I can't glue it from somewhere there. So glue it down. So we've got halfway prepared our backside. And now, to make it like lab book, the opening like this, we need to glue down this what is it? Pair of pages on this side. And now it's up to you. You can make it already like a pocket. Like I made it. Just a minute. I'm gonna find it. Here one of books. I'm still working. Here I made it like a pocket. Here. That page. And it's very easy to do it. Prepare your page with some masking tape or with some packing tape from that bottom to make it stronger, to protect it from ripping off. And then just use glue on these three sides. Oops, no, go ahead. On these three sides and glue it down. And you will have nice pocket. You can also, before you will glue it down, you can also cut out some kind of entry, or use your circle punch and make here just that small half circle, and it will be brilliant pocket. But today I'm going to show you, I forgot name of that pocket. If is it just slip pocket? I saw that on Katy Orta lab book, and I really like that type of pocket. And I'm not sure, because I never purchased any of her tutorials. I like to figure it out, the process myself. I need to think how people did it. I like to find it myself, how it is possible, or just get some small advice and then fight with finding how it is possible. So I never purchased any of her of her tutorials. Even I think she is brilliant. She's very clever lady, and she made pocket. I'm gonna glue it down because without showing you I can't explain it, because I forgot name of that pocket. Here I need a little bit more of that tape here. Hopefully it will be enough. So I'm gonna glue it down, and I'm gonna show you how you can make that slide pocket. It's a very nice, beautiful pocket. I can show you which kind of pocket I mean. Just bear with me, I'm gonna glue down this one. Oops, I'm sorry. Oh, I'm sorry. I hit the cable. I'm gonna glue this down, and I will show you which kind of pocket I mean. This one. Like this. Okay. Good. And I'm gonna show you which type of pocket I mean, because I made it. I made it in this book. I mean, where is it? Oh, here. Aha. This type of pocket I mean. When you've got this small entry, and you have it like your pocket. So I really like those pockets, they are nice. So I'm gonna show you how I am making them. She's doing this pocket in that lab book tutorials, which you can find on YouTube. She's making them a little bit different way than I do it. So I'm gonna show you, just bear with me, Mamma mia, I got here a huge mess, and then I can't find anything. Oops. Maybe. I need some... This one. This will be brilliant. See? I need to put there some opposite color or something what will catch your eyes. Because here I've got that music notes paper. And I wanna see that... Where is that pocket? Where that pocket is? I need to use some opposite paper. I'm not sure how to say that. I have to have a look to Google Translator or my dictionary book. How is that right word? Because I believe I will need that word in the next journal, in the next tutorial as well. So I'm gonna prepare. This is just basic packing paper, really basic packing paper. I used for packing parcel for my mommy before Christmas. So this was left over, and I saved that because it has nice brown color. So now I will need to have piece. I'm gonna make that pocket from here to here. I'm gonna make small mark like here. Hey, come on. Make small mark here. Okay. I'm gonna cut all this around. Not because I wanna use this all piece, but that paper, it's not straight. And I need to just cut nice piece of that paper. So I've got this one. It will be this size. Okay. I'm gonna take my... Look at this. Oh, my dear friends. I've got my first proper large scoring board. Oops. Again, I hit that cable again. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry for that. I've got my first scoring board. This is We Are Memory Keepers scoring board with trimmer. I have to say, I love that. It's a brilliant tool. I should purchase that much more early. Much more early because it's really amazing. Oh my god. I was so silly that I didn't purchase that early. So if you are a beginner and you know you wanna make this scrapbooking, you wanna craft in this area with paper crafting, I highly recommend to save money and purchase that large scoring board because it's amazing. So this is my first scoring board. It cost me 30 quid and it has scoring board, beautiful scoring board, and also this trimmer, which is working really well. It doesn't work with fluffy cardstock. When I've got some fluffy cardstock, it like stuck in that cardstock. But with other papers and with other cardstock, it's brilliant. It's amazing. So I'm gonna cut that paper in size I need. Like this. And I think I will need... Just 1 inch will be good enough, I believe. 1 inch will be size good enough. Or maybe I should do it a little bit bigger. No, 1 inch will be good. And now to make it a little bit decorative, I'm gonna use these are corner scissors. And that corner should be the other way. But I'm gonna use just this end. And I'm gonna cut my paper so it will look like ticket or label. Like this. Those edges. Just a little bit. Oops. Come on. Oops. Oops. Okay. Now, Katy Horta is first preparing like hole on her page, and then she's gluing down this one, and then from the bottom part she's cut out that hole from her like the embellishment around her pocket. But I was thinking if I will glue it down immediately and then I will cut out both sides straight away, maybe it will be good as well. So I'm gonna use my distress ink. Here I'm gonna use black suit from Ranger. Black suit, this one. Distress ink, black suit from Ranger. I'm gonna distress that a little bit. I'm gonna glue it down. Come on, come on, come on. There. Now I'm sorry for my head. It will be there. I know it will be there. I'm so sorry. I'm gonna glue down this one. Oops. Oops. Just try to place it kind of in middle, like this. Or maybe I'm not straight away. And now you will need your knife. If I will find my knife. And you can use you will probably have to use your ruler. I hit that cable again, did I? I'm sorry. And now you will need to... You can make marks with your pen. You can make small marks to make sure you've got it in the middle of that label. So if I will make, this is 2 centimeters, 2 and 2. So I have middle somewhere here. 1. Somewhere here. I'm planning to make hole. This is... I'm gonna make hole from here, okay. 1.5 and 1.5. Ooh, okay. So now I need to cut my hole. I'm gonna use my knife and I'm gonna make 2 lines. One, and then because I'm gonna see that, I'm gonna turn it over. And I'm gonna make line. I'm gonna make like gap between those 2 lines. I think it's 2 millimeters or 1/8 of inch. And make other. Hopefully I cut out both. Well, hopefully. Yes. And this other one, I have it. Oh, here I wasn't so strong. So, make sure you're gonna be stronger than I was. Okay, this line I need to cut out once again. I'm sorry. Make sure you cut that through the paper, not just on the top of paper. Through the paper. Okay, and here I'm gonna use my small scissors, small teeny mini scissors. I'm gonna cut here cap and also on other side cap. Come on. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And I'm gonna use my black suit, wait, not too much, black suit around that gap. And of course, you know, when I can put my head just right over it, it will be much more clear than if I have my head over there. I'm sorry. You know, always when I'm taking video, it's something doesn't work. Okay. And now it will be only up to you to put here some large paper, large page, anything you want. It can be also only cardstock. You can put on your backside and it will make it again stronger than it's normal. I'm gonna glue there just one paper. Where is some paper? So I'm gonna glue it here, just one paper, like this, and maybe, maybe I can make it like a pocket also. See, if I will glue it here, this is like a pair of pages, so one page, I will glue down this way. I'm gonna show you. That top can be, I'm just gonna make it a little bit nicer. Just bear with me, here is just a small bit which needs to be fussy cut out. I left it there, I'm sorry. I'm sorry if you see my head, I am very sorry. Here I left just small bits and pieces. Come on. I forgot it there. Oh, come on. Good. I hit that cable again. In it. Yeah. So we've got our entry. It will look like this one. See? It will be nice. But before, I will glue it down. I think I'm gonna make this not just like pocket, but also like that large pocket, but also like pocket here. Okay. So I'm gonna use this. First fold it in the right way. Fold it. And here you can see why I like to use same size of pages. Because it makes that job much more easy. It's so funny to work with it. And you can find some kind of new pockets or easy pockets. Very easy. I'm gonna glue this down, and it will, oh my hair, it will make this one a little bit stronger, so that pocket will be not ripped off immediately. And now here we will need to get glue on the top. You don't need to have this top free because you will don't put anything on the top. So on the top, and then just on this, what will be glued down, just all around four sides. So I'm gonna glue it down. I'm gonna glue it down. Just bear with me, 4 sides. Okay. We're gonna take off here. This one. Come on. Come here. And now from here, from our pocket. And we're gonna glue it down over it. I'm sorry for my head. I think I will be again in your view. I'm very sorry. Glue that down, and now put double-sided tape or tacky glue here. Glue it down, so you've got your pocket here, which will be your back cover. You will have pocket here, just let it dry. And also, you will have your beautiful pocket here. Something, some cardstock. Do I have some cardstock? I have these. You will have nice, beautiful, large pocket here. And I'm gonna do just one more thing, and then I'm gonna stop this, because it will be again long video. So this will be my cover, and to protect it from rip it off or from fall it apart, it's good to use for your spine. It's good to use some good tape, or I don't remember how you call it, these Craftex. I think it's Craftex or those duct tapes. I've got this beautiful duct tape, decorative duct tape. Or you can use that medical tape, that fabric tape, I think. I've got here, yes. This fabric tape, you can use it as well. And this has so many possibilities to color it, to colors you want. So I'm gonna use this duct tape. And I'm gonna protect my future spine. They are not there yet, but they will be there. So just imagine your duct tape to split on three pieces, like 1, 2, 3. On that backside, on the backside of my cover, I'm gonna glue just one of these three pieces, and two of them I need to have here, because here will be spine, so I need to have cover. Backside, spine, and front cover as well. So I'm gonna glue it down in kind of this order, like I need to lean all those right words, like one part of three of my tape. Oh my god. Oh god, I hope I'm not gonna confuse you now with my explanation. And the same it will be on that other side. Here will be one part from those imaginary three parts. But because I'm working, you know, I'm not left-handed, I'm right-handed. I need to turn it over. So one part here, and two parts are here. One for spine and one for the cover. Oops. So this, it's like decorative element on also like protecting from falling apart. So I'm gonna stop this video now. I hope I hope that you like my labbook pages, labbook journals from old books, and I'm gonna make another video as soon as possible. We're gonna continue to build up some nice book, labbook journal. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for all your support. I hope you had an amazing Christmas. Be prepared for New Year. I hope I'm gonna be okay till New Year. And thank you so much for watching, and see you next time. Bye.